Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel Programming with Gautam. In the previous video, we have seen about required arguments and default arguments, how to use them, how to declare them, and how to use them in a function. So today we'll be learning about the argument length and keyword arguments. So argument length is nothing but we can pass any number of arguments in a function. We just need to declare star and args, and it will automatically take care about any number of arguments that we pass there. So now I'll show you how to use them in a function. Now I'm taking a function called as def. I'll take this as hello and just declare as arg with the arguments are always declared with a single asterisk, single star. We can pass any variable to it. It can be a or anything. Okay, and I'm just putting a colon here, printing a. Okay, now I'm calling the function hello with 10 comma 20 comma 30 comma hello. Welcome to programming with So I am passing 10, 20, 30, hello. I am passing few integer values and few string values. We can also pass list, dict, and list, dict, and tuple. So see, I have taken asterisk a, that is star a, and this is the argument length. So argument length can be of any size. So I am passing multiple values here, few integers, few strings, a list, tuple, and a set. Now let me run it and show it to you. So as we have passed, guys, it is coming in the same way. As you can see, 10, 20, 30, hello, welcome to programming with Gautam, 10, 20, 30, 10, 20, 30, 10, 20, list, string, and tuple. As it is coming. It is not changing anything. So let me show. I'm printing A and ending with end is equal to. So now when I'm printing this, it is ending with star here directly. So we need to write in loop for x in a. Print x and then end with a star. So this is the for loop, guys. I'll show it to you in the further further video. Just to show you, I'm doing this. So we, if we want a star in between of each and every element, we can end with a star and put this thing, or we can also end it with a backslash n. That is next line. Sorry, I took a forward slash. Yeah, as you can see, guys, I'm ending with a forward backslash n and I'm printing this. So it is printing 10, 20, 30. Hello, welcome to programming with Gautam. So as you can see, guys, it is printing everything in sequence, that is 10, 20, 30. Hello, welcome to programming with Gautam. Then the set, then the list, that, and then the tuple in a sequence way. So this is how we use argument length, guys. We can pass any number of arguments in this function while calling it. So this is an advantage we'll be learning in the future classes, future videos. So now we also have another argument called as keyword argument. This is similar to a dict, guys, but while passing, we do not pass the key in double quotes. Whereas if we are passing a string here, we pass it in double quotes. I'll show you now. keyword arguments are always identified with double asterisk, whereas normal arguments are identified by single asterisk. Keyword arguments are identified by double asterisk. So I'm taking a new Python file here, demo 10. I'll show you. So I'm taking a new function called as can be anything, demo. The keyword argument name can be anything, like, guys, like in arguments args, it can be, I'm just taking a random variable name. Print hello. Now I'll call this function demo of, in space of hello we need to pass few values. I'm sorry, I'm habituated to that dictionary, guys. Okay, so I have given similarly to arguments, we can give any number in this as well. We can pass any number of values, but we should make sure that they have a key and a value. So now let me run this and show it to you. So when I'm printing hello directly, it is printing first name to programming, middle name with, last name Gautam. So similarly, in which pattern I have given, it is printing in the same way. So let me pass it with items and show it to you. So this is the items, guys. This is in the, as I have already told you, it is in the dict format. By default, when we are not giving any the key in string, but is by default taking it in the string format, as you can see here. It is taking everything in the list and converting the key and the value of each key and value in a tuple, guys. As you can see, this is the first tuple, this is the second tuple, this is the third tuple. So when I'm calling it in hello.items, it is showing it us in this format. Whereas if I'm just calling the hello variable, the keyword argument name, then it is just showing it in this format, that is whichever format we have given. But by default, it is again converting the key to string, as you can see here. Okay, guys. So we'll be learning about the different ways the functions can be defined in the next video. That is function without arguments and without return, function with arguments and without return, function without arguments and with return, function with arguments and with return. We'll be learning about these in the next video, guys. Hope you have enjoyed the video. If you have enjoyed it, like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Programming with Gautam. Thank you. Have a good day.